If doctors are optimistic about treating cancer with its many genetic faults, then surely disease caused by just one gene ought to be much simpler to treat. Christopher Cassidy loves his computer, in part because he finds sports difficult.
At school, the hardest thing for me is making new friends because they're usually playing sports and I really can't play sports. But what I do is I try to get involved as much as I can. For instance, I was on the student council last year.
Chris has muscular dystrophy, a disease that gradually attacks the muscles of the skeleton, then the heart, and is invariably fatal. Chris's form of the disease, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, affects only boys. The gene for dystrophin protein is carried on the X chromosome, so girls who get a copy have another X with a good gene. And if it is carrying the faulty gene, they get the disease. But although muscular dystrophy is caused by just one gene, treating it is far from straightforward.
The conventional way, or the simplistic way, if you like, of treating genetic disease is to replace the bad gene with a good gene. Easier said than done. Or you can try and put the good protein back in that's missing. Theoretically, all of that is possible, but it's very, very difficult to do.
The Human Genome Project depends upon genetic engineering, using viruses to put pieces of human DNA into bacteria, and using the bugs to grow millions of copies. But using viruses to get new dystrophin genes into muscular dystrophy sufferers remains a long way off.
Well, the difficulty is being able, if you need to target every cell, then it's very difficult. For muscular dystrophy, muscle is a tremendous amount of your body. So you'd have to, for muscular dystrophy, you'd have to get dystrophin into almost every muscle of your body, including your heart. And that's very difficult, particularly if you can't actually deliver that virus systemically. And don't forget the body is going to mount an immune response to the virus.
There is a gene therapy that's much simpler. Just one copy of the faulty gene is present in the fertilized egg each child grows from. Replace that gene, and you have cured the disease. Predictable, and because the engineered gene could then be passed on to all future generations, gene therapy is banned until the child is born.
One of the great disappointments of human genetic disease analysis over the last 15 years since I've been in it is that we've never developed an effective treatment. I would like to see, and I'm sure I will see, if in the next 5 to 10 years, not only one treatment, but several effective treatments for several of these disorders.